Young Money. Ayo, Ferg.
Yeah. Ride with the mob. Alhamdulillah. Check in with me and do your job. Ferg is the name. Bimbola did the chain. Torn off for the watch. Prezi plain Jane. Yamagini chain. Rest in peace to my superior. Hermes Linka feed a village in Liberia.
Action News Network is an Aboriginal American media network. As such, we are protected under the United Nations Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People, or DRIP, Articles 8, 14, and 16. Action News Network is allowed to provide Aboriginal news and media content on non-Indigenous media platforms free of oppressive censorship. Any breach of this protection is a breach of international law.
It's World War III, the Trey. So it's W Square Trey, alright? So we're gonna kick this off, Action News Network style. It's time that we do an update on what's going on in Venezuela and this whole World War III shit, but check this out. We're gonna see what the world, how the world views the US, alright? US must get out of the solar system, all options open, mankind. Ha ha, laugh out loud, best comment of the day. Out of the multiverse, says Annie System. Milos 83 says, get out of Syria first, then we can talk. And this is a response to what our president said to Russia. Exactly. If ever people want an example of hypocrisy or a hypocrite, look at the USA government policy. That's from We all know. The U.S. get out of all those 100 plus states where their military bases are located. That's from Alterno. And Zuckerberg sucks, as the U.S. is the only country that goes around bombing and illegally invading and wonders why much of the world hates them. Action News Network, though, don't hate us. And please remember, you're not descendants of slaves. You're descendants of free people made into prisons of war. Alright. And if you like what you see, please at least hit the like button if you ain't gonna subscribe. But subscribe, hit the like button. Please give you two a middle finger, yo. Alright, y'all, this is from this is Action News Network. We got this report out of Reuters. Alright. This is from Reuters. This is like an associate, like the AP almost, an associated network of news, all right, of so-called news. I'm doing quotations, so-called news, all right. This is where, like, Fox and CNN and all of them, your newspaper, your local news stations, get their reports and stuff. So we got China offered on Wednesday to help Venezuela restore its power grip after President Nicolas Maduro accused U.S. counterpart Donald Trump of cyber sabotage that plunged the South American country into the worst blackout on record. So you got China basically using propaganda saying that Donald Trump and the US were the ones who did it. Were we? I wouldn't put anything past us, would you? But there's a lot of fuckery going on. The shit that's going on right now makes the Cold War, which for some of y'all who are probably under 30 years old, probably don't even know what the fuck the Cold War was, but this was this kind of pseudo war of technology and ideology and tech and, you know, the space race and all that shit between the United States and the former Soviet Union, USSR, the CCCP, the Iron Curtain. You know, this was back in between the 1950s and to the 1980s. All right, I grew up at the ass end of the Cold War between us and them. Right, and it's always been us and them, and to this day it's the same way. We know them as Russia today. At one point, most of that place was known as Tartaria, but that's a whole nother video. Alright, so you got, it says Maduro, who retains control of the military and other state institutions, as well as backing of Russia and China, two of our adversaries, has blamed Washington for his nation's economic turmoil. And announced opposition leader Juan Guaido as a puppet of the United States. Speaking in Beijing, foreign Chinese Foreign Minister Liu Kang. Liu Kang. You can't even make this shit up. All right, so we see. I'm glad to see that Liu Kang has found work after Mortal Kombat. But it says China has noted reports that the power grid has gone down due to a hacking attack. China is deeply concerned about this, Liu said. China hopes that the Venezuelan side can discover a reason for the issue as soon as possible and resume normal power supply and social order. China is willing to provide help and technical support to restore Venezuela's power grid. All right, so we journey over here to BBC News. And, a lot of people saying that Juan Guaido faces sabotage investigation. That he's a puppet for the United States, and the which we call the United States and the EU's interests or whatever, the Western interests and shit. Venezuela's the chief prosecutor, and it says, as you see right here, it says he's under sabotage investigation. Chief prosecutor, Tariq Saab says, you can tell he's not from Venezuela, to whoever Tariq Saab is. Saab, that's a fucking war name right there. Says he has asked Supreme Court to investigate opposition leader Juan Guaido for allegedly sabotaging the country's electrical system. Much of Venezuela has been without power since Thursday afternoon. President Nicolas Maduro has said that the U.S. technology was used to sabotage the electricity grid and has pointed the finger at the opposition, which is Mr. Guaido. The U.S. has already imposed sanctions designed to curtail Venezuelan oil sales and has targeted a growing list of individuals, companies linked to the Maduro government. And this is a standoff. The move against Guaido comes at a moment of high tension in the country, with he and Mr. Maduro each claiming to be the constitutional president of Venezuela. You got Juan Guaido, and Nicolas Maduro, right? So Maduro is kind of like the protege of Hugo Chavez, right? Hugo Chavez, which was in there years ago. He died about a decade ago almost. If you remember the Bush era, he was really the face of Venezuela during that time. You know, they're basically socialists. So the Venezuela is a socialist satellite for both Russia and China. I'm just going to say it right there. It is what it is, all right? It's not like the United States don't have satellites all over the place. Syria was one of them. It's like Syria doesn't want to be part of that anymore. That whole Middle Eastern area is full of U.S. interests and stuff. Not only because of oil, because technically you can find oil any fucking where with the technology we have nowadays. The show domination in that, that very crazy area. We don't know anything about Iran. We don't know much about Iraq. And, Russia has a lot of control over those Balkan states in that area. And that's why we're always in that area. Like that area was like that, baby Tartary, that Crimea area, in Ukraine, this whole fucking region, in the what you would call like the Middle Near East, around the Caspian, from down into Persia and Turkey and all that shit, into the former area of Khazaria, the Balkan and Caucasus states. It's something really weird where they always fighting for that area. And that area was known as baby Tartary, at one time, a little Tartary, so. And of course, Guaido is 35 years old. He's about my age, young guy. This guy, he's kind of like Obama. He kind of even looks like Obama. It's RT. Pardon me if I get my head right. Over here, RT, which is Russian. Russian television, or Russian, news network, or whatever, Russian American news network. Wish they have a right. Russia catches a bad flag. I don't believe everything that comes out of RT, but they do a good non-biased journalism when it comes to American topics, but I don't really buy them when it comes to Russian topics. Their whole thing is kind of embarrassing the United States, from within the United States. It's like the only country you could do that, because I'm pretty sure there's not an AT in Russia, you know, embarrassing Russia over there. But hey, this is the country that we live in and allow, and you know, this is the freedoms that they talk about. So, you know, to each his own. As U.S. officials repeatedly caught out on Venezuela lies, Pompeo accuses RT of disinformation. The U.S. has been calling for regime change in Venezuela for months. In that time, U.S. officials have been caught skewing the facts on the ground and pushing disinformation to the media. But the real bad guy, RT, of course. And of course, you know, Russia is masters of propaganda, so take it with a grain of salt. That's according to U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, who spoke to the media on Monday to give an update on the situation in Venezuela. Right? So, never mind that the U.S. has declared its support for unelected. Remember, this guy, they saying he didn't. It's like this is Hillary Clinton and Maduro's Trump, right? All right, well, Hillary, you know, this nigga, he's saying he got the people want him, but he doesn't have the votes. You know, this shit is really fucking weird. It's almost exactly the same what happened here in the United States. Just, you know, in this country, because we're not a banana boat republic, Hillary had to eventually bow out. But as you see with this fake Russia collusion with Donald Trump, that you know, and if you haven't heard, you should by now, but you know, maybe I am your only news source, who knows? You know what I'm saying? I know we don't like watching the news and shit. Donald Trump has been found not guilty or not having any kind of collusion with Russia, so the Russian shit can go out the window. And it looks like people like Hillary Clinton might actually be brought to, you know, maybe have to stand trial or something, you know. Who knows, you know, usually people in these high positions never end up getting their day in court, you know, but, you know, hopefully maybe, you know, these people were involved with something and, you know, these people are involved in treasonous acts and they will get brought to justice because, you know, mine and your black ass would, you know, and even for a regular poor fucking white person or anybody any color, if you don't, because look at how Jussie Smollett's getting off, you know what I mean? So it's not about skin color, that aspect. And that Jussie Smollett case shows you that, you know, it's whoever they can use, you know what I'm saying? Because then you can look at R. Kelly and fucking and Bill Cosby and say, well, these guys had, you know, all the money in the world and they still, you know, being dragged through the dirt and having to do time and all this other shit. So it's who's playing ball and who's not. Nazi Jussie's playing ball. You know what I mean? So, you know, food for thought. Alright? So, again, as you can see, these, you know, John Bolton, former ambassador, mass civilians killed by the live rounds, the burning trucks. It's just like a bridge going over, probably borders. I don't know exactly where, but this is them probably trying to get the fucking supplies and stuff into Venezuela. Mind you, a lot of this is a couple of weeks old. It's been going on for a couple of weeks now. Only reason I'm really bringing it up is because this is getting real serious. I think we really need to take a serious look at this situation going on here in Latin America. Alright? Here's showing that they blockading Venezuelan aid off the people. It's an empty highway. And this will be a big highway. Could you imagine, like, I-95 on the East Coast or the I-5 on the West Coast or the I-10 dipping down through the Deep South? Could you imagine these major fucking interstates and the side roads being blocked off? You know, preventing trucks and all this shit being blocked off. And if you really look at this shit, man, it looks staged. It looks fucking staged. It just looks staged. It's not car in sight, nothing. Just, you know, quiet, busy, you know, 6-lane highway with a frontage road. You know, and so much for Latin America being real poor. I mean, these highway systems look better than some of the ones. I've driven across country. I've driven from New York to Arizona. You know, I've driven all up and down the East Coast, too, from Florida to New York, you know, to Massachusetts, all of that, up and down to New England. You know what I'm saying? I've been through the Midwest and shit. And this highway infrastructure here looks better than a lot of shit in the United States. You know what I mean? So a lot of this shit is, come on, man. Look at this highway. Mississippi has some of the worst roads in the fucking country. Apparently in the Western Hemisphere, because this is like Colombia or Venezuela and shit, and the highway system's looking banging. So just keep that in mind, you know what I mean? Here's what RT says. The bridge in question, however, had never been open to traffic, but U.S. media dutifully reported the false claim from official anyway. Canadian channel, what's that, CBC, was one of the only media outlets that have clarified the facts when the lie has been exposed. So, like I said, you know, it's kind of weird. You got a nice, you know, highway system right there in that bridge with a frontage road, and there's no traffic anywhere on that shit. So, we got more on Guaido. More on Guaido being under investigation for electrical sabotage. So, you see my head, my antenna is fucking off the chain right now. Okay, so. At noon, 5 p.m. in Italy, this is from an Italian public bureau. Today, Tuesday, 12th of March, the Venezuelan public prosecutor, Terry William Saab, again, that name, man, ooh. They're almost like an American transplant, Tariq William Saab. Anyway, announced that the prosecutor's office of the Republic of Venezuela has launched an investigation against Juan Guaido, deputy of the Assemblea Nacional in office since 2016 for his alleged involvement in the sabotage of electricity system from that country. I'm sorry, let me clear my throat. The provision, which was communicated to the Supreme Court of Justice, the TSJ, I guess, which was taken against the opposition leader to investigate his possible intellectual paternity and the events that struck Venezuelan population from Thursday, 7th March. Exactly as requested by President Nicolas Maduro, the magistrate therefore wants to see clearly about the five sabotages with cyber and explosive attacks on power stations and stations of the electric network. All right, we started a new investigation which is added to the initial ones on January 29 on citizen Juan Guaido for his alleged involvement in an attack on the electrical system. Said the Attorney General, as reported by the TV network Telesur. William Saab also explained that investigation goes hand in hand with that for the reference of criminal acts that Guaido would have made on the justification of violence or even incitement of looting, robbery under the pretext of needs, economics, and messages to the population. So that means this dumbass was like inciting shit to happen, pulling shit happens. I'm gonna be the first to say this shit. Juan Guaido, all right? Juan Guaido is a CIA implant, just like William Saab is, all right? It's just what it is, all right? I know Latin America very well. You cannot call political strife attacking the electrical system, taking away tranquility and the right to life to millions of Venezuelans. It's a criminal coup, and it is a serious violation of human rights, which it is. It is. And this shit's going to come back to bite us in the fucking ass. I believe it's going to happen naturally, but they're going to make it seem like the natural was happening because for retaliation attempts or, you know, whatever bullshit they'll probably come up with to justify, you know, what's going to happen naturally. But okay, so it says at 9 p.m. on Monday, 11 March, two in Italy, Nicolas Maduro, president of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, went up to the Palacio de Miraflores in Caracas and live on television and social media for those without electricity were able to recharge their phones and probably places. He described the details of these stages of the electric coup, which began on Thursday with the sabotage of the hydroelectric plant, Simon Bolivar, on the large Guri Dam. Continued Saturday with the explosion of the primary electric emergency electric substation of Sidor between Guyana and the capital of Bolivar, of the Bolivar state of the same name. Okay, which started operation to guarantee, energy supply and continue on the night of Sunday. Like I said, it's just like written out context to a second substation in Caracas, as anticipated, exclusively by Gospa News, and two more, including that of Cabudare in the state of Lara. The change of the regime's plan, United States purposes, the electrical blackout of Venezuela as a watershed event to galvanize public disorder. Created 2010 by Congress, the NGO that elected Juan Guaido. The memorandum reads like a strategic plan for today's coup. But see what's crazy is gonna be the other outcomes, like the water and all the other shit. Cause check it out, since within a couple of hours, the water will become a bigger problem than the light, tweeted Monday afternoon from the capital, Daniel Blanco, activist of Amnesty International, correspondent of the same media. The river Guayare is already a water collection point not suitable for Caracas, so the water is gonna be the crazy shit. So they're saying 5 days of attention to the electrical system. As we continue to overcome attacks, and at this moment we are again at the electrical service on the east coast of the lake, and where we started working to restore service in Maracaibo and San Francisco from after the attack on the Puna La Piedra, Piedra La Abrahiga line. Then he showed the photo of the Caracas burnt substation. So obviously they found a burnt substation. I think this video this shit on too. Alright, see, when it comes to me, my problem is like these dickheads that represent our country or our corporation, whatever happened. Now, see, my problem with this whole situation and shit is the dumbasses that represent our fucking country or our corporation, whatever have you, right? So, and just to show you that cooning is not just exclusively your reserve for just, you know, just quote unquote black Americans, Negro American, like African American, whatever you want to call us this shit, Aboriginal Americans, right? It's not just a fucking disease that afflicts just us, because this is how civilization is and people were taken down. You know, this civilization is the people that have been taken out that we haven't even heard of. You just now find out about Tartaria. You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure there was some Tartarian cooning going on there. A lot of that. See, the Duke of Tears, you know, is very good with that information. He drops a lot of really good hints. That's the best dude to look on for the true information of Tartaria. Alright, now I'm still learning from him right now, so once I got some information and shit, I'm gonna put together my own thesis, but I'm still in school, so that's why I'm not trying to really go too heavy with Tartaria shit, because I'm learning like everybody else. I heard it before, but I'm straying too far, I'm digressing tonight. But like I said, dickheads who represent us, like Marco Rubio, alright? So this nigga, you know, it says, alright, he had some crazy tweets, right? Over the past 6 weeks, you know, Marco Rubio has used his Twitter account to post minute-by-minute updates and lengthy threads on Venezuela humanitarian crisis, making him a must-follow for anyone keeping up to date with the latest news. It's like him just trying to gain points, man. Like, politicians are the worst, man. They really are. You know what I'm saying? They really fucking are. Alright, though Rubio continues to earn widespread praise from Venezuelans, Republicans and most Democrats for keeping Venezuela plight in the news. It really should be Venezuelan Americans. They don't even see Venezuelan Americans as Americans. Another wink wink hint. It's coming from the Miami Herald too, so you know, it's a very Latin orientated paper and part of the country, right? for his Twitter account amplified 3 inaccurate reports in recent days, giving fodder to those on the left who want to negotiate with Nicolas Maduro instead of getting rid of him. Okay, so back to Rubio, all right? So, as you can see, Marco Rubio is what? I believe he's Cuban. He's Cuban, right? But, you know, as you look at him, and mind you, he's Cuban, and, you know, I'm Puerto Rican on the mother's side, right? My mother, I look like a lot like my mother, so, you know, I didn't get this brown skin or this copper skin just from my, you know, my black American father, right? Because they both the same skin complexion, basically, you know. But if I had another Puerto Rican father or whatever, right? I could still come out looking the same way I look right now, all right? I'll show you pictures of other, for y'all who don't know Puerto Ricans or whatever, we're a really diverse group of people, just like Jamaicans are, just like Cubans are. But, you know, again, me and Marco Rubio are both considered basically Hispanics, right? But look at the difference between us. This is what we trying to tell y'all all at the damn time. So, if we're on the same island, because I could be Cuban, you know what I'm saying? If we was on the same island, who you think is going to be in control of the resources? Who's going to be in control of the government? Who's going to be in control of education? You know what I'm saying? Who? Is it going to be me? The wild Indian? The slave? You know, the Negro, the Moreno, or is it gonna be the mestizo, fucking mulatto, damn near Peninsulares, the España Peninsulares, right? Like the Peninsulares, these motherfuckers, you know, the descendants of the conquistadors and shit. All right, so the same struggle we go through on the mainland, same struggle we go through on the islands and shit, all right? Same struggle. And then the motherfuckers come here and they bring the fuckery pond here. You understand? Them come here and bring the fuckery pond here. Again, with Marco Rubio, who is representing you? So, take this real quick. Marco Rubio, awkward message to Venezuela's Maduro dictators get killed. For much of the past weekend, Twitter account of Senator Marco Rubio was filled with updates on the violence in Venezuela, where the military forces of President Nicolas Maduro attempted to stop a humanitarian aid from entering the country. Then, on Sunday, the account took a bellicose turn. Right there, you see that's Manuel Noriega. Taking down. That's Muammar Gaddafi. Moments before he was killed. You know, that's the look up, man. Like, what? You know what I'm saying? Because I wasn't supposed to have him in Gaddafi, man. But, you know, I told you, cooning is not a disease necessarily exclusive to our people. Because he was killed by coons like that dude right there. Who sold him out for American money instead of sticking the plan with him, you know what I'm saying, and keeping your eyes on that fucking prize and maybe getting that Afro when you going over there and shit. He could have made a kind of a Bitcoin. And I think that's Nicole something from Romania. If I know, there was like dictators of Romania, some shit like that. I think they explained shit. The tweet showed that Emmanuel Antonio Noriega, Muammar Gaddafi, and say Nicolet Cosesu, I believe it is Cosesu, the former dictators of Panama, Libya, and Romania, respectively, first in power, then after being disposed. In Gaddafi's case, the photo was Rubio tweeted, showed the strongman shortly before he was summarily executed by Libyan rebels, you know, or Libyan coons, you know, so on. But Rubio, who's been the most vocal U.S. lawmaker on the situation in Venezuela, that's because Rubio's from Florida. It's a lot of Venezuelans in Florida. He's Cuban, he's Latin, so, you know, it's just, he's cooning on so many ends, you know what I'm saying, that
And Florida's probably one of the few states where you have, besides maybe Texas, where you have a stronghold of Latino Republicans. All right, so there's that. There's that. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry, I've been browsing through a lot of shit for a while, so kind of tired.
Alright, yo, this is from my Fubu News on YouTube and shit. Shouts to Adam, Marf, you know what I mean? I watch this shit, I listen in and crap at night. Yes, some of you guys say be honest. Some of his callers, you know, be very insightful and shit. I like to keep, you know, I like to watch a wide variety of shit to get news, topics, see where the country is going, get it from a black perspective, get it from a white perspective, get it from a Hispanic perspective, get it from an Asian perspective. You know what I mean? That way, you know, I got a ride. I have reality on lock because I know what everybody's thinking, what everybody's doing and shit, what the average man is thinking and shit. Alright? So I'm watching Marv shit like the other day. And yeah, talk about the US military. As you see in the background right here, it says US military gets its ass handed to it in World War III simulation researches, right? So again, shout out to Marv. Thanks, bro. I know you don't mind me getting information out there because it's all about the information. It says troopers fired at the main gun round target Fort Stewart, right? Military war games carried out by RAND Corporation show that the U.S. advantage is slipping. In a simulated World War III scenario, the world's greatest military power loses decisively to Russia and China. Alright? And there's a lot of weird shit. We always beefing, yelling with Russia and China. We always got in these shouting matches and shit with these motherfuckers throughout the year. It's been ramping up again. It was quiet for a while. After it seemed like the war dropped and all this shit, you know, got quiet. Between the U.S. and Russia, you know, was looking like friends for a while, but all of a sudden Putin comes into office and you got a lot of this weird shit going on. Now Trump and Putin look chummy and shit, but there's more to that relationship there than meets the eye, you know, because in some terms I see them, they look chummy, and other times they look like they can't stand each other. So I don't know if they trolling, you know, they trolling all of us and shit, and there's something bigger, you know, in store and shit, and we're just not privy to it right now. We're just not meant to see what's going on and shit, but there's something, I believe, much more going on in it, alright? So, it says RAND's war games pit the United States, the pick them blue, you know, so it basically is saying that we would lose these motherfuckers, alright? Against the imaginary aggressor this time, Russia and China, in these simulated scenarios taking place in either the Baltic region or Taiwan, things don't go well for the United States. So the Baltic region one could really happen and shit, because we're all up in that Caspian, Turkey, Syria, kind of Persia into, you know, little Tari, that kind of area. So that could happen, but really it probably more likely to happen in a Syria area. And Venezuela too look like ramping up, right? That's why Venezuela's real fucking important for some fucking reason. But it's like, alright, how can I put it? This is what's going on. I don't know exactly why they in Syria, but Syria is kind of a crossroad. That whole area, that whole Asia Minor area, that whole Middle East, it's just it really is to keep China. The Europeans want protection from China and Russia, all right? And they're not strong enough as individual nations. They don't even get along with each other, you know what I'm saying? So that's why they had this European Union shit, kind of working like the United States, and like, hey, we all might not get along and shit, but, you know, let's put our military shit together and crap. Still, with all that together and shit, they still don't have the people and the manpower to take on China or Russia. Here's where the United States come into play. So you got the Middle East. Now, all these Arabs out there and shit like that, you have, you know, they used to be Roman tribes and shit, Roman, you know, like, they used to be fucking, like, just, you know, loose tribes running around and shit, okay? So these motherfuckers, like, they have the loyalty to nobody. They're half-breeds. They they ran by the false children of Israel, you know, those I would say Jew-ish, and in the ethnic meaning of liking or trying to be like the Jews, those people. They are in control of like Saudi Arabia and shit. So they have control of that whole shit. Alright. So don't get that twisted. Alright. The Saudi, their families, whatever running, the head guys, the princes and all that shit, they all just a bunch of K czars. Alright? They all a bunch of K czars. They are K czarian people. And they pretend to be God's chosen people, all right? And they are over there too, okay? And they run that whole area, so it becomes a whole breeding ground. So now you got the place that we know as Is It Real over there, and you got, you know, Arabia, you know, which is ran by the same people, which means they're not the real people in that area anyway and shit like that. You can wonder why there's turmoil in between the two. Then you have Iran, which is old Babylonia and shit. This is all part of that Phoenician Empire crap too, right? So that whole area is a buffer zone and a crossroads. Always has been, and it always has been the great ports of Europe and the Middle East and shit. Okay, so strategically, it's the crossroads. It's where the fucking Silk Road began and shit. You know, you got your shit over to Tyre and all these other areas in there, Sidon and shit, and they put their shits on the caravans and they went out towards Tyre, right? Reaching Cathay, which is Imperial Medieval China, Cathay, you know, years and years and years and years ago, right? So that area, they want to be able to have all the military advantage in there to make sure that the Russians keep at bay, because they have up into the top of Turkey. You know what I'm saying? Basically, because they got the Crimea and that whole area over there at the top of the Caspian, right? That's why Crimea is such a strategic point too, because it's very close to going into Persia and the Turkish Persia area. So whoever controls that region has their finger on Russia and has their finger on, you know, Europe. So America likes to be in that area, all right, for both reasons, not just to keep Russia at bay, to keep Europe at bay, all right? And we also doing all these island jumping exercises in the Pacific, along with Japan and shit, who we protect, because Japan doesn't have its own army. We basically cuckold them and took the, you know, they took their ability to defend themselves, basically. So, you know, they don't have no army and shit, so we, you know, that's the minority people, all right? Because they're, you know, a shadow. Their country is a shadow country for the United States, just like North Korea is too, like a CIA kind of fucking shit. But they play ball really fucking well, and yo, as long as they're making them technology over there, making that money and living better than we are here, even though the same people that run us run them, you know, this should be a nod to, you know, the greatness of America and shit. But you know, it is what it is. You know, but this will put shit in perspective. We're been doing exercises out there too, where we're jumping islands, hopping islands like we did in the Pacific and shit, while China is building artificial islands out there. Okay, so, you know, where it says right here, you know, it could happen in the Baltics or in Taiwan. That's pretty much where they're going to probably end up happening. Nobody wants to see a war in the Caribbean. Mostly, why I don't think you'll see a war in America and the Caribbean, why there hasn't been a major war here in a long time, is because of what happened 200, 300 years ago, less than that, 150, 200 years ago, when the wars that happened here put the biblical Israelites in enslavement and the takeover of their promised land, the land that was given to them from Yahuwah himself, right? So nobody wants to blow up the United States and be the ones who fucking killed all the fucking biblical Hebrews. You know, all these Christian nations, even Russia and shit, don't want to do that shit. Even the Chinese has reservations on it, but they're more likely to, you know, not give a damn more so than the Russians might. That's why you had that Russian choir singing and saying, Negroes stay asleep and shit. I mean, because we are.
Why is Russia talking about black people in America? We're the most politically, and when it comes to the real power and economically, you know what I'm saying, we're who owns the wealth and shit. We are fucking the bottom of the barrel. But when Russia talks about the strain, the United States, they show some sort of a warning or concern for the Negroes. Who we know, us here, we know we the biblical Hebrew, you know. But, you know, obviously other people do too, and you're not seeing the signs. They said, you know, Negroes sleeping, and what? Y'all niggas is still sleeping. I barely see anybody talking about the topic. I seen Lex Will, I seen Truth on Veil, but nothing else is popping up on my shit. I'm gonna check again, just before I put this video out, I'll check again so I can, you know, put a redacted statement up, but I'm not seeing nobody talking about this shit. That's all about Jesse Smollett, R. Kelly, everything else, but yo, niggas sleeping, stay woke. That should be the remix. Niggas sleeping, cause, yo, we sleeping, huh? You know what I mean? We sleeping hard. We're sleeping. Niggas is sloth. Alright? So, and it's, I showed you right here, we get our asses handed to us, man. Yeah, man, it don't look good. It don't look good at all. I don't know what to tell y'all motherfuckers, man. Other than to keep it here. And, you know, you better start stocking up on food. I got seeds, man. I even got some weed seeds. You know what I mean? I'm ready. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm going out. I got my vegetable seeds. I got my stockpile of canned fish and meat and shit, you know, nuts and all that crap, and I'll just be gardening and shit, and, you know, growing my own food, and shoot anybody that try to take my shit, but that's about it. So, once again, my face looks fat right there, damn.
Yeah, better, I'm not that, I don't know, maybe it's just the camera angle, that's a little bit better, but, alright. Section Jack, yo, it's Action News Network. You already know what it is. It's the legendary half breed. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? It's the half breed, the agent, whatever the fuck you want to call on that good shit. I really don't give a fuck at this point. But you see, it's time to get it off.